It started with open ears.
So I was listening to this non-Catholic Christian radio station at the request of a friend of mine. As I was listening, I kept saying to myself, that's not what we believe. And I put together some responses in a form of some letters, and I sent those letters on to that station, not knowing whether or not they would read them or not, figuring I would probably never hear anything back from them.
Well, I'm driving along in my car because that was my occupation, and I come across this particular show where they're reading a letter and arguing and complaining about this letter. And they're saying, listen to what he's saying about this issue and that issue. I was amazed, so I pull over. I immediately pull over and I call Johnny and say, turn on your radio, you're famous, okay? they're talking about your letter on the air.
They pretty much laughed off my comments or my on the air and really wouldn't discuss it. In fact, they kept shutting down. They would take select parts of what I had written, took them out of context, and pretty much ridiculed what I had sent in.
We both go to the same parish and we meet after Mass, and Johnny says, why don't we have a Catholic radio station? We don't have to argue with anybody. We don't have to say what's wrong with the other faiths. All we have to do is explain our faith. That's all we have to do. I said, why don't we? Why don't we get to work on that and see what we can't do? So Johnny has a friend, a gentleman by the name of Mike Norwood. Mike Norwood had been in the radio business, I'm gonna say over 30 years. We found a radio station south of Baton Rouge, and the signal just made it into Baton Rouge, and we decided to lease some time on that radio station, and they had just the time for us. That would be from noon to 2. But we wanted something local. Again, didn't have a clue, we just tried this out. Got a laptop, got some recording software, went around and talked to individuals involved with the Catholic Diocese of the Baton Rouge and the surrounding area. We called the show Around the Parish, and it was a daily show. So it took a lot of work to do. It was a lot of fun, but I put it together and submitted it to the radio station to play. The radio station played that show. They played Catholic Answers Live. And meanwhile, we knew some other stations were available because of Hurricane Gustav had come through Baton Rouge and tore a lot of the radio stations up. People who had been praying for the radio station asked me, how is it going? I told them, not too well. There's a station available, but there's no way we can afford it. They told me to do what Mother Teresa does, or did, and that is she would put a miraculous medal in a location that she was interested in, but said, Mary, if this be your will, this be your place. This station was available for sale on the air, no rebuilding, it would be our land. So that was truly a miracle.
In Louisiana, there are more than 44 radio stations with Christian and gospel programming. Of those, none carry Catholic programming. However, this radio landscape is slowly changing. In December of 2010, WPYR AM began broadcasting in Baton Rouge and the surrounding areas. However, does this sound familiar?
WTIX!
In December of 2012, the old WTIX 690, well known along the Gulf South for its powerhouse broadcasting, was baptized as WQNO. Today, both stations cover southwestern Louisiana and the Gulf Coast. And the Holy Spirit isn't done yet.
So it's called Catholic Community Radio, but of course we know that there's more than just radio coming into our ears and into our eyes. Catholic Community Radio is embarking on a bold new plan to reach out even farther beyond radio transmission. As our last three popes and probably the future ones will say, it's important that we stake our claim on the digital continent. If people are there, if there are hearts that are ready to be opened, if there are people who are hurting, it's the Catholic's job to be present there, to welcome them, to give them a voice, and then to explain to them the reason for our hope. And so Catholic Community Radio is going to continue to provide great content. It's going to continue to produce new content, and Catholic Community Radio is also going to branch out into video. Presently at Catholic Community Radio, we have a few programs that are already starting to broadcast on the internet. But it's got to get bigger than that. We have so many Catholics with so many important stories to tell right here in our own neighborhoods. We want to be able to provide a space for them as well.
This includes the renovation of a building graciously donated by the Mercedarian Sisters of the Blessed Sacrament, who have invited Catholic Community Radio onto their campus. There will be facilities for broadcasting live, for production of new programming, and an exciting expansion into the world of video production to take advantage of the many new ways in which the gospel can be transmitted today. Since the WTIX towers were damaged during Hurricane Katrina, they will have to be replaced to comply with federal regulations. When completed, it will give us the ability to increase our broadcast wattage to reach more cars, homes, and even boats.
Whether you've been Catholic for years or whether you're new as a Catholic, we always know that threes are important. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, for example. Well, in broadcasting, threes are important too. A good story has a beginning, a middle, and an end. At Catholic Community Radio, we have three things to ask you. First, are you willing to pray for us? Will you add us to the intentions that you're already praying for? If you've got family members, friends, or things going on in your life, tack us on, Catholic Community Radio. We're also going to ask you to volunteer your time. Oftentimes, people can only give of their time. And if you're willing to come down to the station, we've got things for you to do. Or are you able to make a financial gift to us? There's a lot of work yet to be done, and we're simply trying to respond to the Holy Spirit's call to move forward in this apostolate. If you can help us with that call by providing some of your treasure, know that not only will we be blessed by it, but so many people are going to be blessed by what the Lord is able to do through your gift. However you're able to help us, know that your response is simply responding to a call that began a few thousand years ago with fishermen. The Lord called, they responded, and great things were able to happen. So however you're able to help us, we thank you for saying yes.
The Lord's presence grows with Catholic Community Radio.